rest your head, I'll take you high. We won't fade into darkness, won't let you fade into darkness. Why worry now, you'll be safe. Hold my hand, just in case.
Thank you. Take a moment for yourself. Get close with the lights down low. You and I and no one else. I get the feeling that I wanna explode. Well, welcome to the stream. I'm going to keep the music running now until the game actually starts to get underway. We're just waiting for the other player now. Here we are, second player's arrived. It's Taylor Swift versus Doom Stadker. Sorry, Doom Stadker, whatever, close enough. Not that spelling though, Strunk. Spam spelling. So the first map is going to be Runeberg. It's going to be an interesting map, depending on the tank picks here. Checking my audio right now. I hope it's the correct volumes. Ah, they're already picking, so First pick we have is the 110 from the north. I think that's a pretty strong pick. There's a lot of hold down positions you can use in the north there, and a lot of side scraping opportunities. Although the 110 isn't as strong as the IS-3 for side scraping, but it has better DPM, so it's going to be possibly better in this kind of a fight. So just waiting for the second pick now. It's looking like the WZ-111, that's what's readied up at the moment. Which is an interesting tank. I mean, I would have taken the IS-3 over the WZ due to the frontal armor being quite poor on the WZ, plus the gun being not that good either. Okay, so it looks like we're good to go into the first match. Well, not the first match, this is the second round, as there was an awful lot of matches in the first one. This Invisi tank though. So let's see the spawn, standard enough spawn here. No camo on the 110, bad showmanship. I can switch once we have loaded into the battle, I will be able to switch between both tanks and we can see both sides. Here we are. So let's switch over to the WZ now. Painted in all its glory. I think that's Clan Wars camo as well, Strunk. So both players immediately going for the town, as is per the map restrictions, I believe. WZ taking the direct route, possibly going for the opening shot here if the 110 is to push around. No, leaving very exposed there. The 110 could come this way while you're trying to cross here and get a free shot. But looks like the 110 is going to go and try and either side scrape on this corner or maybe go hull down on the rubble. Let's check it out. I think he's going for the corner here. And this will be interesting. Taylor Swift is going to be caught on the fountain here. There's not a lot of cover you can use. Oh, the 110 is actually circling around here. And this seems to be anticipated. There we are. The first spots have gone out, I think. Or not? Did they not spot each other? They must have spotted each other, surely. Yeah, they have. So now Taylor Swift is kind of pinned down on this fountain. There's not really a lot of places you can go from here, but it's a very strong position, as trying to approach this position will mean you'll likely take a shot for free. While the WZ can remain quite safe and hull down, although approaching from this direction here, this street, there's not a lot of angles you have to there. You have to go back to this part to maybe shoot over, in which case the hull of the WZ can be hit, which is quite weak. Playing very cautiously at the moment now. If a hatch snipe goes out here, that could be very important. No, the shot misses. Very passive play at the moment. Good for DPM, and if it comes down to just an all-out brawl, the 110 is going to win. Assuming that the WZ doesn't get any opening shots off. So if it can be... Well, if this 110 can possibly approach this fountain without taking any damage, which is going to be quite difficult, to be fair. I mean, he can do it from this way if he just goes and angles and tries to get the WZ's very poor accuracy to miss the lower plate. Then he can just go in for the brawl and win on DPM. Seven minutes, they're running down the clock here. That was a blind shot going out there through the bush. Yes, Flyer, you can't use arty, although I don't think it would be very effective because you pretty much have to one-shot the tank you're shooting at or you're not going to win. Oh, that was a heat shell going under the 110. That was a very lucky shot there. So he's able to approach the fountain now. He hasn't taken any damage so far. I think he might take a hit here. No, again, the second shot that has gone under the 110. Now it comes out to a DPM competition and a face hug. This is going to be very advantageous for the 110 because he can hide his lower plate here. But apparently he just goes through the upper plate anyway. GG. It's really a contest of DPM and now individual player skill. That was a nice shot in the turret there. No crits sustained by either tank so far. Still no crits. I'm surprised. I would have thought that would break the turret or something. This is going to be close. I think, unless there's a bounce, we might have a victor in the WZ. Because that heat is just too strong. No, the bounce! The bounce! Oh, GG! Well played to Dom Stadka there. He realized his 110 is a strong 1v1 tank. Very nice DPM, and he could just go in for the fight, and then, of course, that bounce at the end, unlucky to Taylor Swift there. Just caught a bad angle on the WZ's frontal plate there, which is obviously very slope, and with heat you don't get any overmatching or anything like that. That was a good fight at the end there. As far as I know, it is best of one. Let me just double check right now. Looks like it was best of one, so GG. Dom Stadka goes through to the next round, that's into the third round now. We actually have some matches ready to go, so let's try and jump into the next one. My spooky screen, here we go. And you can spaz out to the amazingness of that effect. Okay, we are ready to go into the next game already, nice and quick. So we have Dom Stadka going again for the 110, it would appear, and Wacky going with the T-32, which is a very strong tank on Himmelsdorf. A lot of window opportunities here. An awful lot of side-scraping opportunities that you can use as well, but the T-32 has a very inaccurate gun, which is going to make sniping the 110's hatches quite difficult. Well, the 110 is going to win in the DPM fights if he gets close and he pens all his shells. So I think this may be a bit of a peekaboo fight. for the opening at least, and then someone will try and rush or something like that, and I don't think it'll be the T-32 being that slow. Alright, so my predictions for this game is the T-32 going this way and going to this window here and trying to catch the 110, possibly passing through here or through a window you can shoot them and maybe get one shot of a HP advantage, because if he does that then he can just go for the engagement and it's going to be a quick game. So let's see, it's going to depend on the tank's positions at the start, on how well this is dictated. T-32 appears to be doing exactly what I said. Oh, this is interesting. He's not going for the east side here, which is where the T-32 is going, so there might be some kind of cross courtyard action here. Perhaps he's expected that the T-32 is going to be in a window here or something like this, and he's going to go up the 3-line, which is a pretty good idea in my opinion. T-32 is going exactly where I thought he would, straight to this window, to try and get an opening shot. Now this might be tricky here if he gets spotted. If he gets spotted going across, I don't think he will, because it's a bit of a bad angle for the 32. See, he can't see him here, the turret's in the way. So it's possible that he can come all the way up here with his 110 and catch this T-32 on the hill with his ass to him and just get a free shot, because the T-32 is going to have to turn his turret. Oh! He's not getting spotted! He didn't go back far enough to spot him. Oh, this is this is going to be close. This is going to turn into a nice fight over this hill. I'm just waiting for the moment of realization. Here we go. Nice opening shot there from both tanks, actually. A very high roll from the T-32, rolling 380. And a very nice snapshot as well. The 110 should fire slightly... I think Wacky is using Cola, because there's no way he's going to have a quicker fire rate than the 110. Yeah, this is just a pure DPM contest at the moment. Some wiggling is going to be required to try and bounce some of these shells. I think... Well, now this is similar to the last game. If the T-32 messes up his shot, he's not going to win. But if he hits it, he will. He bounced! he shot the upper plate at too close a range. There's no way that's going to go through. He should have shot again for the hatch or for the lower plate. The 110 proving too strong again, with the second win there. I'll just confirm that this one is a best of one. We may have some... Oh, okay, we have some more matches. This is nice, so Wacky can pull this back. He has two more matches here. If he picks up the wins, he can claim this for himself. Go has been called, we're just going in, same tanks. I think maybe Wacky will take some more time with his aim and try and confirm his victory. We've also swapped sides, so the T-32 is not going to have this window position that he had in the last game. And this one's a bit more dangerous to go to, because if he wants to go there, he has to go through the middle to get there quickly. Or he has to go through the banana, in which case it's quite slow and you can get spotted through the window here. Or he can try going west and going this way. But again, there's a possibility to get shot here if the 110 just goes straight down the middle. So there's a lot of possibilities here. So Wacky appears to be going for the 8 line on the banana, and so does Dom Stadker. So we might have a snipe-off competition. I think the 110 might win that, due to the much better gun. Yeah, Dom Stadker is taking the long way around, so he's not going to get spotted, but Wacky is not stopping. Going full balls to the walls down this 8 line at the moment. Here's the spot. Now this is going to be interesting. The T-32 is going to have a very nice position. So Dom Stadker knows he needs to get the early damage in, but he misses his shot. He put it into the pile of rubble. That's going to make it difficult for him now, being a shot down. Now the T-32 can bounce On that, I thought that would have been a weak spot. Apparently, it's like the IS-3, it's not a weak spot. So he's evened it up a bit now with this bounce. A second bounce! Wacky is not penetrating these shots. All the 110 needs to do is go back and shoot again, and he's got damage. I think. Well, there, finally, some damage from the T-32 shooting for the hatches like he should have been. Oh, that was a no damage shot there into the mantlet. And there's another one from Wacky. Evening up the hit points, 40% to 58%, one shot in the difference at the moment. Another bounce. Oh man, this aiming is going horribly for both sides. Again a bounce off the hatch. Off the hatch, nice, two pens and then a bounce. RNG says hi. Again a win for the 110, that's the match there, that's best of three, that's two wins in a row. Dumpstarker goes through to the next round. So well played to Dom Stadker there. Wacky unfortunately bounced far too many shells in that engagement there, shooting first twice at the hole, which gave Dom Stadker plenty of time to try and aim his shots properly. And unfortunately he also got a little bit unlucky kind of shooting into the mantlet there, but he was getting the turret ring. So good games. So now I think we're going into the next bracket. I think it's the finals now. Let me double check if I can. Yes, we are going into the finals right now. We're just waiting for the other match to finish up. And then we will see, I think, the 110 again. Dom Stadker seems to be enjoying it at the moment. It'll be interesting to see what other tank we see to put up against it. It'll be interesting if we see two 110s. Let's get some music back. Now I stay, but I won't let them.
this should be played at high volume, preferably in a residential area.
Well, here we go. The game is almost ready to go. We're here on Ensk for a best of three. This is the quote-unquote loser's final. It's for third place. We have the undecided third and fourth contestants here, Wacky and Mukto. And they will be competing for the third place prize. And then we will go over to the final, where we will obviously see who claims first place. At the moment, it's looking like a T32 and an IS3. Okay, here we go. Now you have to stick to the confines of the city here. As you can see, it's quite easily pointed out on the map. I have a feeling the T32 is going to go for this window for the opening. Maybe the IS-3 will go for some side-scraping shots here, but he kind of has to cross some ground. Well, we see where he spawns once the timer hits zero. But I think the T-32 will definitely be playing defensive in here, and the T-32 can outmatch the IS-3 in DPM. Oh, the IS-3 actually got a very nice spawn. He won't be shot off the start trying to cross here. So as I predicted, the T-32 is going straight for the window, using the strong turret, obviously, with only a small weak spot on the top. The IS-3, however, has the bigger alpha damage. If he can catch this 32 off guard and get a shot in early, he can very easily win this game if he can pull back correctly and not take damage in return. So the IS-3 seems to have the right idea at the moment. He has an idea where this T-32 might be staying, and is flanking around wide. Oh, Wacky is relocating at the moment. They might completely miss each other. Yeah, they've completely missed each other. It's really funny watching them on the minimap when we can see both. I think Wacky is going to get a free shot right now once he spots him. Yep, here we go. He caught him in the open. That's nice opening damage there. Now Wacky can just go in for the DPM fight. If the IS-3 even bounces one shot, he's not going to have a chance to win this. Now Wacky is playing this correctly. He's backing up so he can try and shoot the IS-3's hull easier, because if he face hugs him like this, he's going to have to shoot at the turret, which is a smaller target. IS-3 knows where to shoot, right there on the optics of the T-32, which for some reason still does damage. IS-3 is down to a one shot now. This is close. He's playing it well though. He's recovering well. If he can wiggle, he should be wiggling his turret, trying to get the T-32 to miss, but nope. Wacky picks up the first game. It's a best of three, if I'm correct there. I don't think it's best of five. Maybe. I'll double check for you, but I think it's best of three. And the first game there on Ensk is going to Wacky. Okay, we're about to go into the second game now. The teams have switched sides. T-32 is now going to be spawning on the south side and the IS-3 on the north. That's going to negate the window position he had early on there. Now I think the T-32 might play this one a bit more aggressively, possibly going straight for these positions and trying to get a side scraping shot here. You can sometimes catch someone on the opening here as they try and cross by. You can get a clean shot and then pull back and you'll have your HP advantage. Then you can go commit into the fight. and win with the DPM. Let's see where the IS-3 spawns. He got a pretty bad spawn actually, he's very far back, normally he'd spawn up around here somewhere. But I think he may actually fall for this, and he may go through the trap here. The T-32, as I suspected, is going straight into the town. He's going right for the opening shot position, maybe. Or no, is he going wide? He might be going one line. The IS-3 is also going one line. If this turns into a peekaboo competition over range, the IS-3 is going to win that fight. Due to the higher alpha damage, and better accuracy actually than the T-32. It's really bad accuracy. Here we go, we're going to have the first poke. There we go, nice damage given out by the IS-3 on the opening shot, but the T-32 actually managed to shoot on the move. He should be side-scraping, yeah, there we go, okay. He's going to take damage there, and he's not going to be able to return any. That's going to throw the HP back in favour of the T-32. If he can bait another shot now and hit the IS-3 once more, I don't think he will though. He's going to back off, re-engage, and then use his HP to his advantage. As the IS-3 will either have to attack him or risk getting rushed, which would not be advantageous in either way. Oh, little does he know, as he could shoot him right now. Ah, too slow. He's going to take damage. The IS-3 with that engagement has thrown the HP a little bit back towards him, but I think the T-32 is just going to rush him now, use the DPM, get the opening shot off, and then I think it may be a GG, unless he starts pouncing a few shells. Oh, that was a little bit of lag there. Yep, GG to Wacky, that's the second game picked up, and I think that's our third place contestant sealed. That was good play from Wacky there, and tough luck to Mukhtil that he got hit on the opening shot there with the T-32 on the move. That was very unlucky. So in third place you have Wacky finishing with I think quite a nice prize of gold. It's a few thousand gold or something like that. It's a very nice prize. And Mukhtil finishing in fourth place. So that's our third and fourth place. We can move on to the finals now to compete for first and second. Let's see if I can get an invite for those. Be back in just a moment with the final. I don't expect it'll take long as everybody's ready to go.
We'll always be together,
together in Okay, so here we are back with the final. Our two players, Dom Stadker and Candy Van Man. Now, we're back on Ensk again. This is best of three, so if someone picks up two in a row here, it is an instant victory for them. Let's see, are we ready to go? Two-minute break, apparently. Okay, well, we'll see you guys in 2 minutes. Go grab a drink or something, you can settle down. See you back in just a minute. You can watch the acid screen. Whoa! Ah, oh, my apologies, we are back in game. They started without saying anything. Okay, so we have the 110 on Siegfried line along with the 112 from Candy Van Man and from Dom Stadker. Okay, so the 112 is going straight for the opening shots here. He had maybe expected the 110 to be crossing, but the 110 is going wide at the moment down the zero line. This is interesting. Well, if he uses his superior armor, because the 112 is not as armored as the 110, and has a much worse gun, unless it's close range where he can use the DPM and hit all the shells at long range, like it's going to be on the 0, 9, and 8 line, then the 110 is going to have the advantage, as well as having the stronger armor against heat, especially from range where you can't really aim precisely. Oh, apologies, I stopped the music. I didn't even notice. So far these guys haven't spotted each other, they're just kind of looping at the moment. I'm surprised there hasn't been just like a random spot through a gap in the bushes or anything like that, but the 1-2 has been kind of hidden around in these buildings for now. I think there might be a spot going out here. Yeah, here we go. The 110 might get an opening shot if he snaps it. Unfortunately a snapshot is missed. They've spotted each other now. And now is Dom Stadker going to turn this into a DPM fight? If so, he may very well win this. First match, it is best of three, so two victories in a row will pick you the straight victory. Unlucky there, the shot has gone into the side with Heaton still did damage right there beneath the tracks. So we're going for the ram. He should have stayed closer for the ram in my opinion, because the WZ is going to be reloaded now. That's the second shot. He caught a good angle on the side of the hull of the 110, which is going to be very weak unless it has a gun angle on it. He's managed to return some shots down though. That was straight to the front plate. The WZ... Oh, a fire! Oh wow, Candy Van Man is a very lucky man to have not been using rations there, or else that would have been the end of the fight. And the first round goes to Candy Van Man. That was a very nice opening shot there on the 110, right in the side with the heat shell. A bit lucky to pen it, but still a nice shot all the same. So the first map, the first match of the map goes to Candy Van Man, and that will put him one up. So if he wins the second one, he will be instantly claimed the victor, and the full 5,500 gold will go to him. But Dom Stadker can easily pull this back. You know, he's got two games to prove he's the better player. So let's see how this goes. Alright, we're straight into the second match now. I think that that first match could have swung very differently if the 110 had connected that opening shot on the ass of the 112. It was just unlucky that the snapshot didn't make the hit. And for the second map, of course, we have swap sides. Now the 110 is spawning north, and the 112 is spawning south. It's interesting that we have Chinese heavies in this fight. They typically wouldn't be too common. Normally you'd see IS-3s and things like that a lot, but it's nice to see some variation. See the Chinese tanks get some love. They're not that popular in the game, so. Now, Candy Van Man in his 112 is going straight down the middle. I think he's going to go to this position here and try and get an opening shot, or maybe to here and try and go this way. While Dom Stadker is, I think at the moment, going 6 line, which would be this way. Oh! Is that a... No, I just see them both. I thought that was a spot for a second. I was about to crap myself, because that would be a ridiculous spot through all the buildings. Yeah, Dom Stadker is definitely going 6 line. I think he wants to try and rush it, and he was hoping that the 112 would be around here somewhere. He's not ready for this, though. His turret's pointed the other way. I don't think he's expecting them to come this way. I think they're flanking each other. And, what, the opening shot goes to Dom Stadker. Nice. He also got Amarak, that is his repair kit gone. If he gets hit in the Amarak again, this fight could easily be over. Track, unfortunately. Is this going to soak in the mantlet or the hull? Yeah, he got a good angle on the hull, so he kind of wiggled to avoid the shot. Damage is done again, he's tracked. He doesn't have his repair kit anymore, he can begin to circle him actually. As the WZ is a very slow turret rotation. This is going to be a close game. There's two shots in here, the 110 is going to shoot quicker. And they both have very poor gun depression, so shooting each other's hulls is not going to be easy. Nice shot there from Dom Stadker, but it's not going to be enough, I think, against this heat shell. Oh, the WZ bounced his heat shell. He bounced his heat shell, possibly hitting the gun, and the second game goes to Dom Stadker. Nice play there. Very nice play. He got the Amarak with the first shot so he could circle him. Then once he retracked him. Nice game. So it's currently tied up 1-1. The next game will be the decider of who will be taking home all of the gold. And we are going straight into the third game now. They should have swapped sides again. I didn't really pay attention if they did. They did swap sides again. Okay, that's good. That was an interesting fight on the corner there. They just kind of spotted each other out. And, no, I don't think either of them were ready for a spot there. So that's an odd spawn for me over here. I can't really see what's going on, but once the game starts, we'll see where the 112 spawns. The 110 actually has a pretty decent spawn for getting straight into the action there. Let's see how the 112 has spawned. Pretty decently, actually, as well. You can get unlucky and spawn down here, but he got it nice on a hill, so he gets some acceleration going down. That might give him the advantage to get into an early position if he wants it. Possibly to go here again is where I think he will go, with the 110 going again for the 6 line. That's my prediction so far. Okay, Candy Van Mant is not going where I thought he would. He's going for the 9 line at the moment, maybe the 0 line to come in this way. It's an interesting play. Dom Stacker is still going up the 6 line. They're not going to see each other here. Maybe actually if Dom Stacker had been 2 seconds later, they would have spotted each other across here like this. But I don't know how close they've been to seeing where they were. So Candy Van Mant is a bit in the open now. If he got caught there, he might be in trouble. For example, if Dom Stacker was here and is 110, he's in the whole damn position. He's going to get a lot of free damage quite quickly. Are we going to run down 8 minutes on the clock without these guys finding each other? They're just rotating around the map now. Oh, if they keep rotating like this forever, they're never going to find each other. Although we do have plenty of time, and the fights usually don't last too long, as it's only one tank on one tank. So not a huge amount of time is needed for the fight. And you have to remember there are battle zones included. You must stick within the kind of grey confines as a rough guideline and stick within the city. There's no roaming out around the whole map or else we'd be here all day. And it was possible there that they could have spotted each other if Dom Stacker was just over here instead. Although I think we're going to see a confrontation here on the north side of the spawn. Or of the base even, the northern base. We're going to see it's going to be in the open again, so this is going to go again down to just individual player skill and how well they can angle their armor and how well they can aim, because we're going to see a close range fight. There's no openings. Oh my god, are they going to miss each other again? They've missed each other again by a hair's breadth. Wow, this is like the third time they've done that. Oh, we might see a spot here. Come on, we have to see a spot. I think that was the spot. No? Didn't? I think Candy Van Mant spotted him there, but I don't think Dom Stacker did. So Candy Van Mant is very kind of cautious in this position. Now, I think he's coming from this direction, and I think he thinks he might be here. Dom Stacker is flanking around though at the moment. He might get a free shot, although he is a bit of a bad angle there, as he might get proxied by the 50 meter rule if he went through that corner, but he's not going there. He might actually get a free shot coming from this way. The WZ's turret is going to take a long time to turn around if he comes through here. Yeah, here we go. If he's looking to the left now, he can get his free damage. Right there, man. Oh, he's missed it. He missed his opportunity. You should always be checking your corners like that. He could have really given himself a big advantage coming into this game. And now we have a proper side-scraping battle. With 5 minutes 55 seconds left on the clock, there's plenty of time for them to kind of juke some shots out at each other. Although this is not the best play in my opinion, the WZ can just kind of poke out on the corner. He could have got a free shot there, as the WZ has higher alpha damage. This peekaboo fight is going to favor him more. Now I think Dom Stacker is realizing the position he's in here, and he doesn't want to be trading with the WZ, as he's going to lose that trade just the higher alpha damage. Although Candy is flanking around, I think he's expecting this, and they're like flanking each other, they're anticipating each other's moves. They've only played 2 games so far and they're already like able to predict you. Here we have a shot opportunity, they're spotted, both spotted. Now you can shoot through here, there's a gap there that you can shoot through, but I don't think that's going to be very useful at the moment. They're going to hopefully have a head-to-head engagement now. or not. They've got 4 minutes left on the clock. It's possible. No, that's a bad shot from Dodstacker. He's going to take a hit from that. Right. Oh no, it's a bounce. He hit the wrong side of the 110's frontal hull. It's going to have too much armor for him. And this is good play by Dodstacker. He's gone straight into the fight. He knows he can shoot quicker. He's just taking the hits, getting the damage out. Because in the end, he's going to win a DPM fight like this. If the WZ misses his first shot like that. As you can see, the 110 is just shooting quicker. Of course, having the lower alpha damage. Oh no, that was unlucky. He's hit the upper plate at a bad angle. He still has his repair kit though, so he can keep moving. He can maybe get one more shot. He needs to make this hit count. Oh, it's a bounce. That's unlucky. Also a bounce from Candy on the 110's hull again. The WZ's heat is not being very reliable at the moment. That is one more shot in the fuel tank for Candy. He's bounced again! He tried to go for the driver's port. That is not a weak spot, as we found out earlier in the semi-finals, and that is a win for Dodstacker. Congratulations to you. Nice play. That is 5,500 gold. GG. That was a really close battle. All three of those games came down to one shots. There was no clear kind of advantage in any of those. You know, both players trying to find each other on the map initially, and then when they find each other, you know, just the misses were what lost them the games, really, in all three of those matches. For the two that Candy lost and the one that Dodstacker lost, it was always just down to the misses. Never their positioning. Their positioning was good. The angling was pretty good, but Candy shooting twice on the WZ's hull at a bad angle, unfortunately bouncing his shells, and then hitting once on the driver's hatch, which is not a weak spot at all. That really kind of sealed the deal there. So I hope you enjoyed the tournament. This has been my first cast ever. I would appreciate if you're new here, you can follow my stream and see when I go live. I stream many times each week with very high level gameplay. Maybe you can teach me something, I don't know. I'll see you next time.
champions of the night. We are the champions, the champions.